So in this tutorial, I'd like to show you some of the new features in S-Contract Design 2014 that you may not have seen before. As per previous tutorials, you know how to bring in an external image from a PDF file or a TIFF file and bring it into a drawing. The other method of drawing a building or a building perimeter is to simply just use the line command or click on line on the toolbar. Pick a start point. And as you can see straight away, you can actually drag the mouse and click on any point that you want. For greater accuracy, you can actually type in the distance. So if we type in 12 meters, which is 12,000 millimeters, we can just then press enter and the line is drawn. We can continue on like this, point to a 45 degree angle, for example, and type another distance. This wall I'll make 20 meters, which is 20,000 millimeters. Then I can do a C for close. So there we have our building perimeter that we've just manually drawn using a line. We can then go to the pull down menu and build the plan, or we can click on the build plan on the toolbar. And there we have our plan layout. As per the other tutorials, you can continue editing this plan as normal. If I decide that I want more control over this and decide that I just want to manually draw the walls myself, I can just undo that and click on our make wall option. As you may be familiar, you can actually click on line and follow a line that's already on the screen. So if I simply click OK on that, click on the actual line, we follow that line on the screen. However, going back to make wall, we can now also click on custom and specify the number of bays. So if I know that there is a wall that we need to follow and we decide, okay, well, I know that that wall is about 20 meters long, I'm going to put 6 bays on there. Simply click on the number of bays required as being custom 6 and click on OK. We can then point to where we want that wall to go manually, and we don't have to follow that wall. In this case, I will. And we select our bay length, and there straight away is our 6 1.2 meter bays. We've improved some of the editing to make it much quicker. An example of this is simply just click on the actual bay that you want to add, whether it's east or west or left or right, and then click on the actual bay you want to add to. So for example, if we wanted to add a 1.2 meter bay just to the right of this middle bay, just click on add bay on the east, just point in that direction, click on the bay, and then specify the length we want. So let me show you that again. If I wanted to put a bay to the left of this 2.4 meter bay, just click on the left option, click on the bay, and in this example, let's just add a 0.7 meter bay. And it's added it and inserted it to the left of that bay, and it's automatically pushed those bays along. I can always use move wall and move it along if I want to. Going back to our make wall option, we can also click on make wall again. And in this case, we'll have no side brackets. We're going to force it to be a straight line using the ortho method. And we're going to build 3 bays, 1.2 meter wide. Click OK. We have forced straight line, so therefore the line is automatically straight. Click from left to right. And we're going to specify 1.2 as the length and therefore we have 1.2 by 1.2 meter bays. If we want to add a birdcage or a dance floor, go back to the toolbar, go to copy wall north, click on the bay that we want copied north, specify the width, and there we have the start of our birdcage and dance floor. So as you can see, we have easy toolbar options and an improved make wall facility to help you draw your plan quicker.